Hey there everyone, welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to see how you can use local storage in your React app. Let's get started. All right, so right over here, I have nothing but a simple project to show you how you can use local storage. Now, if you have used local storage in the past, if you have the basic knowledge of local storage, then it will be very easy for you to use it with React as well. Now, let me explain to you this app. So all this app contains is just a normal counter. So if you click on it, the count just keeps increasing. If you click on the reset button, it resets. And if you click on it once more, it just goes ahead and counts it. But what I want is that when I refresh the page, it comes back to zero. I don't want that to happen. I want it to persist the state. So right now, this is the state that we have. It is count, and set count is the function that we are calling to increase the count. Now, I also have this extra line over here that vibrates the device. So if you click on it, the device will vibrate. So this is not important for you to understand right now. So how do we persist this state that we have right over here? First thing is first, we need to save it into the local storage. Now, if you have basic knowledge of local storage, it will be damn easy for you to understand it. Now, if you want to follow along with this, make sure to check out this link. I'll put this link in the description below, where all you have to do is you can just get the whole boilerplate code that we have in our app, and then you can just follow along just like you would in VS Code. All right, so if I just right click and open inspect, so the dev tools open up, and all we want to do is if we go to the application tab, you'll find local storage right over there. And ignore this item right now. So first, what we want to do is we want to create an item in local storage. Now, how do we do that? So basically, all we want is just when we set count, when we change our state, all we are going to do is we go to the new line and we're going to say local storage dot set item. And what we want to set item, so let's give it a name. So the name is going to be count, that's what I'm going to name it. And the second argument is the value. And if I set count like this, this will work just fine. Now, there's a little problem in here that you should address. So right now, count, if you look at it, it's a number, right? So if I just hover over this, it's a number. And the set item expects a string. Now it's going to implicitly convert the number to a string, but we should do that also. So I'm just going to go ahead and say .toString. So let's just call that function. Now, if I were to go ahead and click on this, it's 6. If you go back to the dev tools, you'll see right now it's 5. So that's a catch, because React works differently. If you change some state and then you try to access that variable, you cannot do that. It will return you the old value of that state. Now, to fix this, we have to go ahead and add a use effect. So if you don't know use effect already, you just go ahead and learn that first, because you won't understand how it works. So I'm just going to call use effect, and it will automatically import it for me. And then inside of use effect, I'm going to pass in a function. Now, inside of this function, all I'm going to do is just going to call this. So this line, let's grab this, and I'm going to put it right in the use effect. And now in the use effect, the second argument that I'm going to pass is the dependency array. And I'm just going to pass in a count right over here. Now, if you are having a lot of trouble understanding all this, all we are doing is whenever the count variable changes, which means whenever this state changes, we want to run this piece of code. We want to set it to local storage. That's all we are doing, right? If I don't pass in anything right over here, this will set this state on the start of the app. So basically, when the app first starts, it's going to run this once and only once. And that's why we pass in count right over here, so that whenever the count variable changes or the count state changes, it's going to run this code again and again. Hit save, and let's remove this extra line of code. And now if you look at it, right now it is 0, and I'm just going to click on this, and you see the state and local storage updates at the same time. But that's one thing. But what if you also want to get the state? Right now we are setting this in the local storage, but if I refresh, this resets back to 0. And that happens because we have our initial state as 0. So first, we also want to get that item. In that case, what we can do is we can just go ahead inside of here and we can say, well, hey, local storage dot get item. So basically get an item from local storage, and what item we want to pass in the key, which will be count. That's what we name it. And if this does not exist, meaning if there is no count coming from local storage, meaning if we just go ahead and hover over this, it will return either a string or null value. So all we want to do is if it is null, then So if we just add an OR statement, what this will do is it will get something from local storage. If it does not exist, it's going to reset it to zero. So let's hit refresh on this. Right now it is zero. If I change in anything, you see another problem appears. So the problem right over here is that I showed you it returns a string or null. Right now, our local storage is returning a string back to us, and that string is zero. If you go inside of here, this is how it looks like. It won't tell you it's a string, but it is indeed a string because everything in local storage is stored in the string format. So how do we fix this? Well, the simplest way to fix it is just pass in a plus before all this. So basically all this plus does is that it will convert that string to a number. Let's hit save and you'll see it gives us to us 5 ones. Now if I click on this one more time, you'll see it increments now. So if I reset and let's refresh now, you see this is how it looks like. So if I just go ahead and change this, hit refresh, it is 7. Hit refresh, it is 7 again. Hit refresh, it is 14. And that's how you can implement local storage in your app. This is how easy it is. But this code is also a little bit complex. You see, you convert a string to a number and you set an OR statement and you have to call the use effect, which is kind of a lot of code, right? Well, in that case, if you want to make your lives easier, what you can do is just go onto this website, usehooks.ts, right? And you can just go ahead and see, look for the use local storage. So you'll find a hook. Now these people have made custom hooks. So if I just go ahead and control F and I'll search for local storage, you see use local storage, right? And all this is they will give you the code for the hook, and they will also provide you how you can use it. But right now, I don't want to copy and paste this whole custom hook, right? Instead, what I'm going to do is, if you just go on now available on npmjs.com, they show you, you can just install the package. So all we are going to do is let's copy this command, and I'll just go ahead and then we'll pop open the terminal and we'll paste that command right over here. So all this is going to do is just install usehooks.ts. Once it is installed, we'll just go ahead and import something from usehooks.ts, and let's import the use local storage. So there are a lot of hooks. You can look into every one of these. I'll put the link in the description below. Now you can use it just how you use state, right? So all you can do is just run const something is equal to use local storage. Now first thing is the key. So what is the key? The key is count. What is the name of our local storage variable? And then once you have count, then pass in the initial value. So this initial value is zero. So if the local storage does not exist, we want to set it to zero. Then when you look back, all we see is dark theme and set is dark theme. So the same thing for us, we are going to have the count and set count. And the next thing is that we don't need this line at all. And we also don't need the use effect, right? If we just get this out of the way, if we save right now, so we have a problem. Somehow the package is not working fine. So I'm just going to go ahead and restart the dev server. And now here we go. It works just fine. So now it reads the value from local storage. And when you change it and when you refresh again, it will still give you the same value. And if I reset it, let's go back. It works just fine. And then we also don't need this unnecessary. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you like it. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know in the comments below what other type of videos you want to see. This is just a short video about local storage in React. Let me know what you think about this. The code for this will also be on the GitHub repository, so make sure to check this out as well. I'll put the link in the description below. Finally, thanks for watching.